In the hidden world of aviation, where creativity has no limits, an amazing double-engine spy-flying boat, the Blackburn B-20, stood out. It was a unique blend, taking the best parts of both flying boats and floatplanes and making something really smart and elegant. Is the unique ability to split in half of the Blackburn B-20 a brilliant illustration of aviation going above and beyond to make aspirations hands-on reality? Ever heard of an aircraft that could literally split in half and take flight? What if I told you the Blackburn B-20 did just that? Let's discover the intriguing story of how this unique aircraft could split in two. In the world of aviation, back in 1936, flying boats ruled the waters but stumbled when it was time to take flight. Enter Robert Blackburn, the mastermind behind a secret project. The problem at hand? Flying boats, those aquatic marvels, seemed to forget how to fly once they hit the water. Major John D. Rennie had been working on a solution that would revolutionize flying boat performance. What was the secret recipe he had in mind? It was none other than the B-20, a flying boat with a surprise up its sleeves. It was similar to a magician performing a stunning trick, but in this scenario, it wasn't a rabbit, but an aircraft that split in two. That's right, you heard correctly. An aircraft that could separate. This was more than just a routine takeoff. It was going to be an aviation spectacle, the kind that makes you scratch your head and say, "Wait, did I just witness an aircraft breakup?" To tackle the tricky takeoff and landing issues faced by flying boats, Robert Blackburn had a groundbreaking solution. He divided the flying boat's hull into two parts, connected by extendable struts. During takeoff, this ingenious mechanism would extend, lifting the engines and propellers high above the water. It also positioned the wings at the optimal angle for takeoff and landing without being fixed at that angle. As the Blackburn B-20 took to the air, its extended hull was retracted by four strong jacks. This transformation turned it into a sleek aerodynamic marvel that produced significantly less drag than conventional flying boats. Blackburn received a patent for his brilliant idea, which included retractable wingtip floats. Why did the Air Ministry seek a high-performance flying boat? And what were the exact criteria they set for this extraordinary aircraft? The Blackburn B-20, developed in answer to the Air Ministry's request for a high-performance flying boat, smoothly incorporated these innovative concepts. Strict requirements had to be met, including a weight of under 25,000 pounds, a minimum speed of 230 miles per hour, and a minimum range of 1,500 miles. Its unique design attracted the attention of the Air Ministry, and early in 1937, a prototype was created. The B-20's design in the late 1930s was a unique blend of conventional and unconventional thinking. The upper section of the hull and wings were constructed in the usual manner, while the lower section, known as the pontoon, stored a significant amount of fuel. The main wing was built in a single piece and had three spars attached to reinforced frames in the hull. The B-20 had an exclusive look thanks to the retractable wingtip floats, which were akin to the extended hull. The aircraft finally left the slipway in early 1940, boasting an 82-foot wingspan, a length of 69 feet 8 inches, and a height of 25 feet 2 inches when the hull was extended. While the prototype was unarmed, planned production models were armed with 8 303-caliber machine guns for defense. The B-20 had a crew of 6, with creature comforts for extended missions, including sleeping quarters, an officer's wardroom, a small galley, and a toilet. Marine equipment was stored both inside the hull and on the pontoon for convenient mooring during bad weather. The B-20's innovative design turned it into an oversized floatplane with an extendable hull, adding height and requiring the use of a folding ladder for access. Although it exceeded the Ministry's weight specification by approximately 30%, the aircraft was equipped with 2 experimental Rolls-Royce Vulture engines. These engines were chosen because of an unanticipated weight gain during manufacture. On March 27, 1940, Flight Lieutenant Harry Bailey piloted the B-20's maiden flight. While it demonstrated excellent water handling, the aircraft experienced a catastrophic aileron failure during high-speed tests in April 1940. Tragically, only 2 of the 5 crew members survived, and 2 others were never found. After one of the B-20's Vulture engines became entangled in a fishing trawler's net, the wreckage of the aircraft was discovered in 1998. The engine is on exhibit at the Dumfries and Galloway Aviation Museum in Scotland. What do you think about the B-20's remarkable but ultimately short-lived aviation journey? Comment below.